friends, welcome to the national webinar on visualizing post-corona in India with special reference to economy, trade, commerce and innovative technology being organized by Punjab University Constituent College, Nihal Singhwala. I am extremely thankful and I extend my heartiest congratulations to Dr. Kuldeep Singh Ji, Principal Punjab University Constituent College, Nihal Singhwala and members of the faculty for organizing a webinar on a very topical issue of visualizing post-corona in India with special reference to economy, trade, commerce and innovative technology. The principal and staff of the college deserve appreciation for this. I am extremely thankful to them for inviting me to deliver the keynote address for this national webinar. My dear friends, since December 2019, the whole world is struggling with COVID-19. Everything is locked down. The major part of the world is locked down because of the fear of this COVID-19. Indian subcontinent is also witnessing its impact from the February last to till now. There is a complete lockdown from March 22, 2020 and some states are under curfew. Large segment of the population is under fear. The Indian economy has expected to lose over 32,000 crore rupees every day, that is $4.5 billion. Up to 53% of the businesses in the country were projected to be significantly affected. 92% of the Indian labor is in unorganized sector and has no work and they had lost their jobs. Supply chain has been disrupted and supply chain has been put under stress. A large number of farmers around the country who grow perishable are also facing uncertainty. Various businesses such as hotels and airlines are cutting salaries and laying off their employees. My dear friends, this COVID-19 has impacted our economic growth. Our dream of 5 trillion economy is washed away for the time being. Our manufacturing sector, our real estate sector, accommodation sector, food sector, tourism sector has been severely affected. It is an estimate that 10.5% work hours has been reduced. Our large segment of our population, that is 25.7% in the rural areas and 13.7% in the urban areas, is living near poverty line has been severely affected. Startups has almost been finished. Out of 130 crore population, 20 crore MGNREGA workers are not able to earn anything during this period of lockdown. And this lockdown has impacted very badly and has put up various challenges for us. According to a World Bank report, there will be labor supply shortage, that will people are moving to their native places and are in no mood to return back. And it will pose a major crisis to the industry as well as to the agriculture sector. Our trade cost is going to increase in the future whenever the lockdown will be open. Public, the people has affected badly. They have experienced so many things while living in their houses. They foresee that in future also such kind of crises may happen. So public will cut down in expenditure, that is at least 60% cut down in the expenditure of the people of the whole world is expected, which is going to severely affect the every sector of the economy. Remaining 40% of the amount which the people will spend, they will be only spending on the daily needs, that is grocery items. That means major shift is expected in the buying behavior of the customers. Tourism industry is going to be finished for the time being because there is a corona fear in the minds of the people and they will not move to the hill stations and they will not be compulsorily living in the hotels and having food in the restaurants, etc. So there's going to be total shift in their behavior. This is a very, very big challenge for all these type of sectors to survive in future. There are a number of industries which has been severely affected. For example, our financial service sector, our auto sector, information technology sector, foreign direct investment, mutual funds, cements, crude oil. These were already having negative growth even before the corona period. But now after the corona, this has been severely affected and their growth will be negative in the future also. Here, I remember Ratan Tata's statement which has been recently made by him. He said, year 2020 is not a year of profit, but of sacrifices and saving life on the earth. Very true, sir. Very true. We have to underline these kind of narrations which has been made by an experienced industrialist of this country. We need to observe the economic parameters need to be redefined, not in terms of growth percentage in the GDP, but in terms of happiness and health index of the citizen, in terms of social security of the population, in terms of quality of its human resources, in terms of quality of immunity of the population. So growth parameters need to be redefined in 2020 and in the years to come. So therefore, the growth parameters should not be the growth in the GDP only, but it should be considered in terms of happiness and health index of the people, social security of the population, quality of the human resources, and the quality of the immunity of the population. Our industry leaders need to redesign their growth strategy, sharing profits with the customers and other stakeholders. Ratan Tata has rightly said, it is not an year to earn the profit. It is a year to share the profits with the different stakeholders so that we can come out of this crisis. Being honest as a taxpayer, producing environmental safe products and services, efficient pricing which suits all the stakeholders. We must use the indigenous technology. We must give the importance to the local MSMEs. We must explore the possibility of using the local raw material instead of importing from the other countries. Choices between dying with the virus or dying with the starvation. If the lockdown continues, then people will die with the starvation. If lockdown is open, then people will die with the coronavirus. We have to analyze the situation. Here the statement of a very big industrialist of India, an honest industrialist of India, Narayan Murthy, is very, very important. He said, India must accept the coronavirus as the new normal. Otherwise, if lockdown continue, hunger may kill more people than COVID-19. So it is for us to decide how to make strategy to come out of this crisis, because we cannot have lockdown for an uncertain period of time. For a very long period of time, our people will die with the starvation. We have to think something to do, prepare certain standard operating procedures to live with the corona. Only then we can grow and go ahead in the future. A scientific approach is needed, my dear friends. A very scientific approach. Approach which has certain new parameters in mind, which has a vision in the mind. We have to strengthen Make in India initiative. Our Prime Minister yesterday announced in the national address that we must be self-reliant. For self-realization, we must strengthen the Make in India initiative. We must develop the commercialization of the indigenous technology. We must develop the technology-driven, transparent public distribution system. We must have the efficient rural healthcare delivery. We have to drastically reduce our import bills if we want to survive. We have to adopt emerging technology domains like artificial intelligence. We have to look after both demand and supply challenges if we wish to live with the corona and wish to live happily with the corona. We have to be self-reliant. Self-reliant supply chain is needed. The total focus of self-reliant villages need to be there. Our brand equity need to be redefined. Every citizen has to become brand ambassador for local made products and services. Indian made brands needed to be given more importance. Our demand pattern needs to be changed. For that, our lifestyle needs to be reoriented. My dear friends, our priorities need to be redefined from individual to the government level. We have to become our own brand. We have to develop a new vision which is synergic, which needs a synergetic rethinking required at all levels. An honest and visionary approach to develop India is required. A broad plan to deal with corona type exigencies need to be developed. We have to prevent another COVID outbreak. This will be critical for any country or business. A new wave of COVID-19 will be hard to recover from. We should start preparing detailed COVID-19 guidelines and make it mandatory compliance for companies post lockdown. Businesses should put in extra effort to make sure factories are COVID-19 compliant. This step will also build confidence in the workforce and will ensure better population. My dear friends, we have to convert the crisis into opportunities. The world has never witnessed such type of situation. This is an unprecedented situation. We are locked and we are working from home. We have to convert this crisis into opportunities. Every crisis has new opportunities in the carpet. We should not waste this time. We have to utilize these opportunities for the benefit of humanity. We have to invest in ourselves and find a new way for this purpose. There are certain challenges which are post-lockdown challenges, and we need to ponder upon these challenges if we wish to go future a very safe and happy for everybody. Another looming issue of post-lockdown will be the lack of workforce or manpower. Most of the workers are migrant and may not be able to return to work soon. Companies will end up operating at a very low capacity. This will require businesses to take up substantial measures for worker safety and providing benefits like housing near the place of work, etc. Businesses will also require to think out of the box and establish processes to employ available workforce efficiently. For example, multiple shifts, as an all available workforce cannot work together due to COVID-19 guidelines, providing other benefits to the worker utilizing available capacity of units, etc. You have to find out unanticipated demand. The COVID-19 pandemic has impacted the supply chain across the globe. Post-lockdown, it will be very difficult for the businesses to predict from where and at what level of demand will come. Businesses should activate scenario planning teams. These teams will help cover multiple demand scenarios and plan solutions accordingly, managing other stakeholders like vendors to ensure supplies. This is a very difficult situation. Very difficult situation, and we have to come out of this situation with vision, with a positive thinking. Only then we can go forward. There will be a liquidity crunch in the market. Whenever the lockdown will be opened, there will be a immediate liquidity crunch in the market, and how we manage it, that will depend upon the vision and efficiency of our business leaders. Businesses have started facing massive working capital cash flow issues due to lockdown, and they will continue even post-lockdown period because of the reduced demand. MSMEs and startups are worst hits. Though the government has started taking steps via various agencies, but still we need to do more. To help these small businesses, government can also procure from MSMEs and startups, thus helping to sustain in future. Our supply chain need to be focused. Once lockdown is lifted, one of the most crucial thing to make sure we are on the path of exponential growth is to ensure our physical supply chain operates seamlessly without any obstruction. As a country, we should have to define clear guidelines on movement of goods. States, businesses and industry bodies, we need to work together in making all this happen. We have to connect with the universe. We are not masters of the universe. We have to change our attitude with regard to the universe. We have to take care of each and every segment of the universe. We cannot live by ignoring the environmental factors, my dear friends. Every sector needs to be redefined. Every sector needs a standard operating procedure to be followed if we want to live happily with the corona after post-lockdown period. My dear friend, it is not the responsibility of the government only. All agencies, all individuals, from all levels of the people, from the lower part of the democracy to the upper part of the democracy, we have to work together. It is not the responsibility of the Prime Minister or the Council of the Central Minister or the Council of Ministers of the States. It is the responsibility of each and every part of this country to work for it, to devise policies, to suggest to the government, to prepare themselves for the post-lockdown period. Only then we can survive. Otherwise, survival on this earth will be very, very difficult. My dear friends, we have to think that we are not the only persons who are living on this earth. There are a number of species which are living on this earth. If we ignore them, If we consider that we are the masters of the universe, nothing other supreme power is there, we are going to lose. Another COVID-19 situation will reoccur if we do not change our attitude. We have to change our attitude. We have to change the business styles. We have to change our lifestyles. Only then we can survive on this earth. And I hope, I also congratulate once again to the principal, Dr. Kuldeep Singh ji, for organizing a seminar on a very topical issue, because we need to discuss all these issues, and the faculty of the college is highly appreciable for organizing this seminar, and I hope this discussion will continue, and the papers which will be presented in this seminar and the resource person will deliberate on the various issues which needs attention of the general public also, and each and every segment of the business also, so that we can have a prosperous India. We can now know how to live with Corona, because Corona is the ultimate reality which is not going to go out immediately. The time will take. Vaccine will be developed. We have to live with Corona, and we have to ensure that in the future also we should not allow to reoccur these type of situations, because these situations occur only because of our faults, because we ignore this universe. We are not caring about this universe. We are selfish people. We have concentrated ourselves only on our needs. We don't care about the universe. We don't care the environmental factors. That's why we are facing such kind of difficulties. We will become human beings. Only then such kind of things will vanish from this universe. And this universe will again be a very, very good quality universe, where every species will live very good and happy life. Thank you very much. I once again congratulate the college for organizing this topic, this seminar on through the virtual, because these are going to give us a new experiences, and every teacher has to be tuned according to the new environment. That's why this college has taken a lead, and I congratulate once again. Thank you very much.